Hello everyone, this is sorry for coming in a little bit late. This is the field trip video for Acte and the kickoff video for Acte 19-1. Someone is passing by, they didn't look like want to be in the video. In here you can tape wherever you want, but when people look like I don't want to be taped, well fine, no problem at all. Now, this video is a field trip video because Haarlemmerplein, it's a very good location for, but not for the Yellow Fest. So I'm going to do a field trip to a place where something is available, which a lot of people in here do not seem to have. Now, where shall I pass? On the backside. Okay, on the backside. Because this is a little bit like a typical place. Everyone can go crisscross. Now, get up. Yes. So today I have a new thing in mind. The Yellow Fest in the Netherlands. It's of the egg. Oops. I don't want a fine. Here. Only the boots, mannen. Police everywhere. Then better walk with the camera. Hello.
This is not mine.
Hmm?
This is not mine.
Do this horse? Nein. Guten Tag. So now I need to walk. There are like 6, 7, 8 agents. If I see agents, I play by the rules. If I don't see them, well. Anyway, so the field trip is starting funny. I have no idea. Yes, it feels different. Different with this corona and these high fines and so. And all the things you see as a Kelber Western in the, as a Kelber Western, as a Yellow Fest, as a Sea Laid Down. All the things you see when people want to do demonstrations, which is a fundamental right, how the police responds if you want to do a demonstration for something that nowadays elites do not seem to want. Now, these police, they are not interested in me at all, I think. I'm going to bike on the pavement with the camera. Because I'm not allowed to bike on the road with the camera. Right. Okay, right, let's do it. They are not interested. And if so, I get a fine. It will happen sooner or later anyway. Okay. Here we go. Because otherwise, I want to make a 10-minute video. Maybe 15. Otherwise, the video will take more than 10 minutes. And we don't want this. Now, okay. On the bike again, camera. Now, on one hand, in more and more situations, the police, of course, because the politicians want this, is way too eager to end demonstrations. Everyone gets driven over the nuts of some virus, what's the name again? Everyone gets driven over the edge because of it. Not me, but when everyone is over the edge, it, yeah, sometimes it works on your nerves. But anyway, yes, field trip. On the way to, this is nice to see. Look, this is I. The black part is I. And here, there are two people not recognizable. They are sitting on the shores of the I, because these days, and there is no climate crisis, but there is an environment crisis, Amsterdam is a heat island because of the sunshine all day. Now, these heat islands, they have an impact on the way the wind blows. So it has an impact on where it gets very cold in winter, where it gets very hot in summer. Because the wind patterns are changing because of all this. Now, but they are changing. But the global temperature is not changing. There's no evidence at all that the human beings have an impact on the global temperature. Now, having that said, yes, field trip. So I have a new location in mind. In the Netherlands, everyone who can count to 10 and is not completely nuts has left the Yellow Vest movement. So. Either I can not count till 10 or I'm nuts, but I'm still in the Yellow Vest movement here. Now,
So I was thinking, the people in the elephant movement who are still here, they need education. Yes, they need to be educated. Because educated people will only vote for Geert Wilders if they like fascism. Because what for a part fascist, his party, is on some points fascist, is fascist. Fascistoïde we say in Dutch, but when we use swearing, we call it fascist. Yeah. So these people, they need education. Education, because you cannot be a fascist and the yellow fascist. And they need to have education. They need to make up their mind. What am I going to do with my life? Am I going to be a Geert Wilders fascist, like swearing fascist? That official term in science, fascistoïde. Remember that? So am I going to be a Geert Wilders voter? Or am I going to be a yellow fascist? So where do you get education? Here, at the library.
So, here am I. This is the outfit for Amsterdam City.
I do not feel... Someone was asking me when I was on the way to here, I found a bike that was left behind. So I took small parts of, and then some kids talked, well, kids, not really kids, like people around 18, 19, 20. Blah, 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 blah. And one girl, that is a very interesting issue, talking about that. Well, this tire up front, it's too wide. You shouldn't take it with you. Oh, okay. And then she said, it's always like this with the blue ties. And then she asked me, do you have speed? I seem to look like a speed dealer this day, or a speed user. I never use chemicals here, people, definitely. Alcohol, caffeine, that's all for me. Now, and of course, I can't say this in the video, but it's only visual information. Nice topic for the video. So, whenever you walk the street in Amsterdam, 10 years ago, there were all kinds of people, usually from England, from being a racist here, work the red light district. Now you have people, the tourists are come, and now you meet local people again. And what do local people ask? Do you have speed? Okay, good to know. Now, music, please. This is a song about Macron. Hello. So what more do we have? The flag? Do we have space for the girl is looking but she's not joining in the party yet. The man has two. They are entertaining, this is Amsterdam, you can see you can say it. A very important aspect of a new location is can I put a flag somewhere? And if yes, where can I put a flag? Now, the only place where I can put a flag is where the camera is. On first look, the only place. Yes. Okay, the location feels good. This person here was very interested, and I think it's someone who is living in this area or is living on Kaansam Island. It looked like someone more or less in the middle class.
So a big difference with Haarlem Plein is the people who are here, they are not used to anything going on here at night at all. This is Oosterhoek's Eiland. It's a bit of a... it's where the catered communities are, and there are some hotels, there's a library. I'm going to give it a go for a couple of weeks. The quiz, oh yes, the quiz. With a quiz, you need to be able to win something. I have something people can win. Look, this is what people can win. A yellow fire start. This is the ID. Now, if I do one quiz, I will put event online and so, and I have a couple of weeks to think about it, because if I put the thing online, I can invite people on chat and only let people who I know from the library and people who I've invited take part, because there is no way at all I'm going to do GLS's Amsterdam Krijtmolen events with people who are wearing yellow vests but are voting for a fascist party. Fascistoïde, or who want to push the right values, like left-wing views on economy and more conservative views on family values and culture, because it went a little bit too crazy in the 70s here and there. Of course, people can have different opinions, but when you want to push the exact same agenda, I sometimes mention, because ideology is not my primary reason to be in yellow vest. I want a fair system. That's the reason. Because when the system is fair, the rest is effect. So we need a fair system. But yet, a lot of people, most people would consider me to be a left-winger, but might find appreciation for our own cultures a little bit remarkable for a left-wing person. Well, left, right, left, right, left, right. But people who are pushing the same agenda, but are like, well, this is the right agenda, but most people are not supporting it, so we are going to manipulate things or so. Lots of people passing by. Hello. Bezig with the video. They are totally not interested. It happens. I think there are people heading for the car or something. Something in that corner. Not familiar with the customs. Sometimes I'm asking myself, am I familiar with this person? Anyway. This location does feel a little bit out in the open, but it's a very good stage. This in fact is a stage. I have to get used to it. This is perfect. This is a lot less challenging part of Amsterdam than Haarlemmerplein. Haarlemmerplein is not bad or so. Really bad areas in Amsterdam are very rare. And there are some areas which are less rough than Haarlemmerplein, but where a lot of people in the area are completely not okay with people making videotapes. They're the kind of people who make money with, well, with drugs trade or something. What kind of hassle? Hassle is it's a Dutch English word, hasselen, hosselen. There are no junkies here. There is no one doing drug trade here. There is no one offering stolen bikes. There is no trade in stolen bikes here. nothing of all this, nothing. It's also, there are people passing by. This is the first time I'm coming here for the video. It's one at night or something. Even at one at night, a lot of people are passing by, but it's a very hot night. This might have some influence. I think I will make, I will first get the hang of this location, and then I will decide if I'm going for every Thursday here at 10, and most likely only invited people, and people I know from the library, because I'm a promoter, I make videos. I'm an organizer, but I'm a meetup organizer. I'm not a revolution organizer. In the Yellowfest movement, in political uprising in general, at this moment in the Netherlands, it attracts a lot of people from the flanks. And on the flanks is where you find a lot of nutcases. You find the nutcases in power, in the middle, and you find the nutcases on the flanks, more or less. At this moment, the middle is very big in the Netherlands, and the establishment, the political establishment, is rotten to the bone. De Jonge is a criminal, Rutte only cares about power, Ollengren is a sleazy person. I'm not going to mention Halsema. Yes, people are getting very negative about Halsema. People, Halsema is not in the Dutch government. Halsema is the mayor of Amsterdam. People, you seem to have forgotten that the Yellowfest here in Amsterdam have been on the doorstep of Halsema much and many times, and not even one arrest, not even one. How would you like it when there are, the Yellowfest might like it, but how would you like it? For example, when you work for a bank or something or whatever, when from time to time there are a lot of Yellowfests in front of your house, some even saying things which might impact your health someday. I mean, so Halsema is the mayor of Amsterdam, which makes you relevant for Amsterdam City and Amsterdam area. And in the last couple of days, some more or less kubbels, NSDAP, NSB, are like small internet newspapers. In Dutch, they started hammering Halsema again. Halsema was cracked down on some virus you might have heard of again, because the virus is spreading again fast. Now she wants everyone to be more careful. A couple of months ago she did something, well, I would say very stupid. She's good in doing stupid things from time to time. Police. Let's see what happens. Nothing. Maybe it's handhaving, not police. Halsema is the mayor of Amsterdam, so in Amsterdam City, in Amsterdam area, she's relevant. Halsema, so far, has made problems about demonstrations. Halsema is too negative about the people who have very right-wing views. People who have very right-wing views, they have all right to hold demonstrations. So, of course, when you have very right-wing views and everyone is free in the science, this is not nice, and this is also not right. Demonstrations should be allowed.
Here, Booking.com is going to build a new head office. Booking.com, one of the many companies from hell, I think, but I'm not sure. I know one person who used to work there. Not a very nice person, someone who is very strict on the people who are lower in the organization and does everything what people who are higher in the organization are saying. The humane way to do it is the exact opposite. Be very critical on people with power and be soft on people with less power. That's the right way. But anyway, everything is turned upside down. This is also why we turned the Dutch flag upside down. I'm not going to talk about the flag now for a very long time. I wanted 10 minutes. I'm seeing 39. Here is the moon. It's like 21:20 to the crease now. Here there are some people chilling out. They are not recognizable on the camera. There's an ambulance there, it's Amsterdam nighttime. A bigger shot of the Oba. And I might do something fun with the flag. No, I will save this for next week.
Aha, my security. Hello, meneer. U komt niet herkenbaar in beeld. Ja.
Ja, ik zou die weg willen halen en daar niet op het bordes, in ieder geval, dat kan niet, want daar gaat het alarm op.
Oh.
Hier doet maakt niks uit hoor, maar...
Jullie alarm gaat erop af?
Ja.
Nee, dat is niet leuk.
Nee.
Ik blijf op het bordes filmen.
Nee,
want...
dat mag niet, want het is ook grond van de bibliotheek.
Dus ik heb een recht van demonstratie en één persoon...
Ja, demonstratie. Ja, dat klopt, maar niet...
U valt me in de reden, meneer. Dan kunnen we geen normaal gesprek hebben.
Niet op het bordes.
Ik heb een recht van demonstratie en eenpersoonsdemonstraties hoef ik niet te melden.
Dat zou kunnen, maar of het wordt is, die grond wordt bij de bibliotheek.
Ja, dan bellen jullie de politie maar. Okay. Ik heb een recht op demonstratie.
Nee, dat is goed.
Want, nee, niet nu. Ik haal die vlag weg.
Okay.
Ik kan me niet om te escaleren.
Nee, okay.
Maar een andere keer.
Je mag gewoon demonstreren, dat is geen probleem.
Precies.
Ja.
Een andere keer. En op het moment dat jullie van mening zijn dat, dat het recht van demonstratie niet van toepassing is op jullie, dat bordes. En ik ben van mening dat het wel van toepassing is. En de politie komt om een standpunt in te nemen. Dan volg ik gewoon wat de politie wil. Maar als de politie zegt, ja sorry hoor, maar daar gaan we niet voor komen. Nou ja, dan word ik kennelijk gedoogd door de politie.
Nee, maar ze komen wel hoor, want dat bordes hoort bij de grond van de bibliotheek. En u mag hier voor, u mag hier overal, mag u demonstreren. Maar daar moet ook de beveiliging weer op de ring, de straatbeveiliging.
Op het moment dat jullie alarm afgaat, dan houd ik er absoluut...
constant af.
Dan houd ik er absoluut rekening mee, want dat is niet leuk voor jullie.
Nee.
Maar op het moment dat jullie mij mijn demonstratierecht op zich ontzeggen op het bordes...
U mag gewoon demonstreren, maar niet op het bordes.
Dat mag dus wel. Dat
hiervoor? Nee, want dat is de grond van de bibliotheek.
Dan hebben we gewoon een volwassen verschil van mening. En op het moment dat ik er weer voor kies om daar te gaan filmen... en jullie zeggen tegen mij dat mag niet, dan zeg ik van nou, dan wil ik graag weten wat de politie daar zelf van vindt en of ze het belangrijk genoeg vinden om te komen.
Ze komen hoor, dat is geen probleem, want we hebben het al vaker gehad, ja.
Ja. Nee, maar dan volg ik gewoon wat zij aangeven.
Want wij kunnen ook nu het alarm niet opzetten en dat moet gewoon doen.
Nee, maar dat is dus het hele punt. Ja. Op het moment dat het alarm afgaat en dan geloof ik je gewoon op je blauwe, bruine, wat even ogen, dan verander ik de positie.
Ja.
Maar op het moment dat jullie alarm niet afgaat en jullie zeggen het mag niet op het bordes, dan zeg ik sorry, ik heb recht op demonstratie.
Nee, maar het alarm gaat af en sowieso het bordes is... officieel echt de eigen grond van de bibliotheek. Kijk, hiervoor maakt het sowieso niks uit.
Het
maakt niks uit, dat is geen probleem.
Het recht op demonstratie vindt mevrouw Halsema heel belangrijk. Ze heeft daarvoor de dam vol laten stromen.
Nee, maar dat mag ook, buiten kijf. U mag dat absoluut.
Ja, maar je mag dus kennelijk in Amsterdam regels breken als je wilt demonstreren.
Ja, maar niet op grond van de bibliotheek.
Als de burgemeester het mag, mag ik het ook.
Ja, dat kan de burgemeester doen.
U lacht.
Ja,
blijven lachen met
we
elkaar.
Lachen,
en als de politie hier komt en zij zegt, meneer, we willen dat u weggaat, ga ik gewoon weg.
Ja,
maar nu haal ik de vlag sowieso weg.
Ja,
en ik ga over drie minuutjes weg en denk er even over na of ik hier volgende week weer kom.
Dat is geen probleem. Ja,
we hebben gewoon een volwassen gesprek gehad.
Ja, absoluut. Ja.
Ja. Ik ga meteen weghalen.
Ja,
dag. So, yes, people, this was a conversation in Dutch. There are two problems here now. First of all, the alarm is going off all the time, they say, because of the flag I have positioned. Now, I have no reason at all to assume the alarm is not going off because the flag is positioned here. Yet they are also saying I'm not allowed to hold demonstrations on this platform. Now, then I'm saying the mayor of Amsterdam is breaking rules when she finds an a demonstration important. Ik ben over 5 minuutjes weg hoor.
Ja, is de fiets ook voor nu meneer?
Ja, die is ook over 5 minuutjes weg.
Ja, als u het wil opruimen graag. Ja.
5 minuutjes. Als je over 10 minuutjes terugkomt, is die helemaal leeg.
Is
die volgende week denk ik even over na.
Kunnen wij het alarm er weer opzetten?
Ja, ik had geen idee dat het alarm af te gaan. Dan had ik het niet gedaan.
Succes in ieder geval, hè.
Dank je, doei.
Ja, ja.
So, when the alarm is going off, this is not nice. So this is a valid reason, but when I say I cannot hold demonstrations here, while at the same time the mayor de facto organized a demonstration, and this was for BLM, and I support the core message of BLM. This does not mean I support everything people do with it. I'm also not taking part of it. I'm busy with Yellowfest at this moment. I do not feel 100% at home at this location, but the idea of the quiz at first is at 10,
also because I know some people here. I really like this idea, and this alarm, and so, well, at just between you and me, everyone who's watching, I'm not too sure if the alarm goes off, but it's very possible. I think it's more like they are seeing me on cameras, and it looks weird. Okay, let's do the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bye.